Okay, so we are picking... Oh, hi. Welcome back, everybody.
We're
picking
up
from where we promised we would pick up from where we last left off, from where we were sitting on the pleasant couch.
Yeah.
So, now...
I'm just going to, you know, run all the way back and pick up that crowbar. Not crowbar, but the metal pipe that's now bent to all to hell.
Get whatever items you can get at this point. So...
There we go.
We were talking about fourth dimension.
Oh, yeah, on our live stream.
Yeah, on our live stream that carried over. For those of you who have absolutely no effing clue what we're talking about, I was saying during our live stream, or during our latest live stream.
Well, what the?
You ran forward a couple shifty steps really quick.
That was interesting.
He's like, Joe. Do your thing.
Yeah, hold on, let me shoot down. God dang it, there's no checkpoint here.
Our last checkpoint 6 minutes ago.
Yep. Oh!
I think that was a death shot.
No. His brain splattered everywhere, though. Hey, Fred, how's it going?
Homing brick! Ooh. Oh, you got a bullet.
Thank you.
Sweet.
From a gun that... Okay, I was about to say from a gun that just has one bullet now. Okay, I need to get this guy. Come on, Joel. Come on, Chuck Norris, shoot. If you guys would stop shooting!
Don't look away! Because you know they have ridiculously good aim in this game.
Oh yeah, I don't think he's noticed me though.
But all right,
I'm gonna wait till they stop shooting. Okay, now he sees me.
Yeah, good thing you moved.
Yeah. I'm trying to...
My god, if only we had that kind of bullet
resistance. You know what? I'm just gonna sneak up behind him. This is crap. Well, I'm not gonna waste my bullet on this guy.
Yeah.
Because he should have been dead by now, but on this mode, all it does is stun them.
Yeah. What I was saying before was, I had watched Game Grumps and, during the Mario...
Oh, did they finally get him?
They did.
Really? It took about 15 or 20 shots for him to finally die.
I would much rather do that than what we were doing before.
Yeah.
Which was a lot of dying.
Oh, what?
Scope Mag.
Oh yeah, now I have 2 bullets.
Blue cobalt. Now you have 3 bullets.
Yep, I only had 1 bullet before.
Yes.
Alright, so I'm gonna switch that back over because I still want to use this because that was powerful. I don't want to waste it yet.
So I would just let
them... Oh, there we go.
Nice. Do their thing and kill other people as I talk.
Yeah.
So,
throw a stick up behind them.
What I was saying was, I watched Game Grumps and on episode 31... it's episode 31 and 32 of the Mario Galaxy playthrough,
yeah.
Where Aaron is comparing one of the level layouts to a Mobius strip. And, excuse me, for those of you who don't know what a Mobius strip is, you literally, if you take a piece of paper, right, and you rip a thin strip out of it, lengthwise, and then twist that strip...
Oh, he's got one of those.
Give it out.
Oh, okay.
He's dead. Nice.
Because Ellie shot him. Those actually kill.
Nice.
Let me guess. No checkpoint yet, but hopefully after I talk to him.
Yeah. Or you got to get up close to him.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to. Yeah.
Checkpoint.
Mm-hmm. Okay? Finally.
But we've been fooled before.
Yes, we have.
Direction, then Maria was like, we gotta run, and so we dove over these tables, and this huge guy blasted with a shotgun.
Slow down. Listen, hey, are you hurt?
No.
God damn it. I need to talk to you.
Oh, he sees the relationship with the girl now.
Yep.
You tell him to go find somebody else. Maria, I can't have this hanging over. Do you have any idea how many men we lost here today?
And what's that all about?
You.
Yeah.
Does that have anything to do with me?
About it later.
Did he tell you where the lab is?
We'll talk about it later.
Later. Right.
Yeah, he's trying to do whatever he can.
I fuck up and then I turn into one of those widows,
yep.
Okay?
I have to do this. I don't know what else to say. Here we go.
You. If anything at all happens to him, it's on you.
he's going to die.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, I know. I'll take that girl of yours to the Fireflies. You don't have to worry about it.
It's best this way.
You know, maybe some real good will come of this.
I need to talk to Ellie.
Now remember this part.
Joel!
What is it?
That girl of yours. She took one of our horses and rode off.
Damn it. Which way?
Come on.
Oh, boy.
I think she may have heard us.
Oh.
Go back inside.
Yeah, how much would I bet she overheard us?
Yep. So you were planning to abandon me?
There.
Yeah.
That was part of the deal the whole time.
Yeah. Chuck Norris Jr. Away!
Right.
No, he doesn't need to be riding. He needs to be standing up like this.
I didn't even know that you rode horses in this
thing. Yeah. That was one of the cool things was about this part, because look at this thing.
Yeah, I'm impressed with the detailing on the horse, the sheen on his coat.
Yep.
She couldn't have gotten far. We'll find her. Don't worry.
Stubborn kid.
She usually pull these stunts.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Wait, I'm trying to remember. Can't get off? No, I can't get off yet. Because I was trying to remember, I think I can come back here walking, but I couldn't remember if there was a secret that you can only do if you get off the horse.
Mm.
But nah, you can only get off the horse when it's scripted.
But yeah, so you take a thin strip of paper, you give it one twist.
You go down this way.
That's just a 180 degree twist, and then you connect it to the other end, and that is your Mobius strip. And on the Mobius strip, it said that an ant or some kind of small insect should be able to, from its starting point, walk completely around the strip and walk on both sides of the sheet of paper without touching an edge.
Yeah, it's basically like an infinity symbol.
Yeah, because of the twist that's in it. Well, he also brought up Clein bottles, and what a Clein bottle is you take that same Mobius strip and all you do is connect the edges of that Mobius strip that are extended, and that's your Clein bottle.
Oh boy. Yeah, at least it knows how to go back home.
Yeah.
Goddamn many. Go around, I'll cover you.
So this is where the other marauders were.
Yeah, this is where the marauders' hideout was. Seriously? You better be dead, but really point blank range. Well, boy, aren't you in a pickle? Really?
Nice!
Wasted my Jack Daniels on you for nothing! Alright, that guy's got a sniper rifle, don't want no troubles with him.
Oh,
he died, I was ready to throw it at him. I was like, why did it hit the edge? Because he died. Like,
yep.
Jack Daniels was wasted on you.
And I gotta say,
before
I continue, that the game, it was a little time that we had to spend to get up to the point where we hit that most recent checkpoint.
Yeah.
The game was literally dicking with the hatter the whole time doing stuff like that.
Yep.
But yeah, so he was talking about Clein bottles. And that spurred a conversation about four-dimensional space and about our ability to see four-dimensional space. And now I will hand it over to Hatter to explain.
Yeah. There is a slight possibility to, I wouldn't say perceive it per se, because to perceive it, you'd have to have a complete thought process of it. But the, ouch. Yeah, apparently you don't like this idea either, but too bad.
Mm-hmm.
The best way to think about it is if, crap, woo, boy. The best way, they do not like me at all. Oh, hello, friend. Didn't see you there.
Yeah.
Alright, me need the bullets here.
You just left me out to fight by myself.
Yeah, well, you were on fire, so I didn't really think you survived.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, where you going? Oh, that's why, stupid stump. Alright, so, best way to picture.
Whoa.
Oh, hey, friend, how's it going?
Behind you.
Yeah.
No, that was your brother behind you.
Yeah, that was my brother. I wasn't worried about him. I was worried about this guy. Alright, get out of my way! Alright, what I've been trying to say without all the interruptions here. was if you ever look at your finger, if you ever put your thumb down and try to like stare off in the distance on your fingers, you'll see five fingers instead of four. But as we were talking about, too, best way to explain it is when everything is like in a two-dimensional plane, everything is flat, even though it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Oh crap! Darn it! I knew I wasn't gonna be able to get it.
You were doing good though.
But the best way to think about it is if you put two fingers, both of your hands behind each other, and try to line them up. I guess best way to try it, at least your best, line up the middle fingers up, mm-hmm. and do the same process of trying to blur the image in your hand for like a millisecond. Your brain will be able to perceive the plane,
mm-hmm.
but it can't fully become a thought because it's gone like that. So yeah. You'll see it. You'll see it like an inspiration or what do they call it?
An aneurysm.
Yeah, basically. And then you go, and then it's gone.
Yeah.
Like,
oh, wow.
Yeah, like that.
I wish we were flame retardant like our brother.
Yeah.
Oh, now he's dead.
That one kind of likes to die a lot.
Yeah.
But yeah, so literally you can perceive it technically for a millisecond before it's gone.
Yeah, and just a brief recap of what we mean is with the Clein bottle. The Clein bottle is a four-dimensional object that we are trying to perceive in three-dimensional space. And what Hatter was saying with the lines is, if you did watch the live stream, which we went into great detail at the end of it, about it, is it's like if you are... Damn.
Yeah, he moved out of the way at the last second.
What? How did he survive?
I know, right?
Like, if you're... Let's say that you are a two-dimensional drawing, right? You can only move in two directions. Left, right, and up and down. Those are the only two axes that you have to move. And if you are a two-dimensional object and you're viewing other two-dimensional objects, since you are laying on a plane where you only have those two axes to maneuver in, most likely everything, unless you change the physical axes in which you're viewing things.
I completely forgot that was not my brother. He was behind me. That was my brother.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well.
You're only going to be perceiving the lines in the empty space in between those lines. Until you change the axes and get an angle and a different viewpoint on whatever you're looking at to see more of it.
Yep.
In three-dimensional space, you have three axes that you can move on. So, two-dimension, you have an X and a Y axis. Up and down, left and right. In mm-hmm. three-dimensional, you have X, Y, and Z axes, Z giving things depth. So it's like left, right, up, down, forwards, and backwards, right?
Yeah, basically.
So basically in layman's terms, yeah. So as a 2D creature, you cannot perceive things in 3D because you don't have that forwards and backwards axes to move in.
Yeah.
And it's just like with four-dimensional space. Now it's like W, X, Y, and Z. W, X, Y, and Z axes that you have to move in, where instead of forwards and backwards, you have another variable axes that you can move through. That we naturally, as three-dimensional beings, can't move through.
Finally.
What?
Bow and arrow.
Oh, nice.
Finally got one. At least I know where it is now. I was happy about that. I was just looking around to see if I could find health or bullets.
But, so what the thing about the Clein bottle is Clein bottle is a three-dimensional Mobius loop that is closed. The Clein bottle, just like the Mobius loop, is a one-sided, one-surface object.
Yeah.
Where the Clein bottle has no edge. So, for the Clein bottle to work, like what I was saying in the live stream, if you have, let's say you have the figure 88 or the infinite loop, right?
Yeah.
You, in our world, if you have, in the 2D world, the intersection would be where the two loops touch for the 8. And that's the only thing that you would be able to have. Well, in the three-dimensional space, if you move forwards and backwards, you can elevate the loop, or elevate the middle section loop so that the middle sections aren't intersecting, but the eight is still intact and it's still continuous.
Yep.
Wow, nice.
That was
great.
Weird
glitch move.
Thank you, Gabe, for working with me on that glitch.
Yeah. And it's the same principle in the Clein bottle, where
I looked behind me, I shouldn't have.
It's the same thing.
Crap. Oh, wow. I don't think that was not my brother, man, by the window.
No, your brother was still in the room with you.
I thought it was because he had the blue jacket on, or the denim jacket on. That's what confuses me. He keeps running around everywhere.
Yeah, well, he's a badass.
Yeah, he's trying to help.
He can take Molotov cocktails to the face and survive.
Yeah, and apparently his bullets can actually hurt.
Yeah, which I love.
Come on, finish him off so I can move.
With the Clein bottle, it's the same principle where, okay, you have this closed one surface object. And when you look up Clein bottles, you have a bell-shaped bottom, an arching neck that curves back into the bell shape, into a loop that goes, or into an opening that goes into the quote-unquote bottom of the Clein bottle.
What the? He glitched way over here.
In fourth dimensional term, in three dimensional terms, a piece of that Clein bottle has to intersect the other one, creating a point where they touch.
Yeah.
Well, as a fourth dimensional object, that piece that would normally intersect in the third dimension, which is what we function in and what we use to give it shape and define it in meaning, it would raise into that fourth axis, that W axis, that we don't normally perceive.
Okay, that was weird.
Under normal circumstances. He sucker punched the shit out of
me. I know, but I don't see how he heard me or anything. I was sneaking up behind him.
Neither do I.
Oh, well, Clein decided to say, we gave you one, now we give one back.
Yeah. And so, much like the two-dimensional creature, once it moves into the third dimension, it's imperceivable by a two-dimensional creature because it's outside of a plane that it exists on.
Yep.
Or it can function on. So when it moves into that fourth dimension, it disappears because that's outside of the realm that we can normally perceive as a part of normal thought.
Yep.
So it looks invisible. It looks like it's constantly warping and molding and moving in and out because we're not perceiving fully the fourth dimension. Now, like Hatter said, we can perceive it in small spats in small doses.
Yeah, it's just it's far beyond our comprehension to form as a thought.
But that led us that long, lengthy discussion, which was far longer in the live stream video. I highly encourage everyone to go check it out because it was really cool. Led us to the topic of our potential as human beings.
Mm-hmm.
Because we see movies like Lucy.
Mm-hmm.
That's the name of that movie. Lucy, another movie, Limitless, where you see humans unlocking the quote-unquote full potential of their mind and being able to do things mentally that normal humans can't do. In the extreme case of Lucy, she was able to warp reality.
Yeah, because she fully started adding up the 1,000% of her brain.
Yeah, and you said that technically we're only using, what, 1/1,000th of our brain?
Yeah, because it's not 100% per se. There are basically 10 parts of our brain, and each part, it can potentially open up to 100%. More people use, like, certain parts of their brain that has 15%. Some people have 20% that part of the brain, and then there's other ones that have different numbers, basically, to put it. Mm-hmm. But if you would put it as 100%, it would technically be, yeah, I know, right? 1,000% is what we're looking for. And the more we help unlock those specific parts, the more they can interact with each other. And basically, yes, you could almost be like Lucy.
Yep. So you can warp reality. Oh.
Hey, friend, how's it going? Okay, that was weird.
No!
I hit him.
Wow.
Everyone saw that. It was there. The game just wouldn't let me hit him.
That was crap.
I'll remember that next time. Giant rock, apparently, even though it's not in front of you, can block your shot.
Apparently, the hitboxes for the surrounding environment is
And no hanging bottle on that one.
Wow!
Jack Daniels, you betrayed me! We've seen the homing bottle before. It didn't want to that time.
Yeah. You've seen homing bottle, and you've seen homing brick.
Yep, that one was just bleh.
But it's utterly amazing. Like, we talked about this particular concept on the show before, where you have people give themselves surgeries in order to, quote-unquote, forcefully unlock the portions of their brain and open up their mind.
Yep. Ouch.
I had never seen the movie Limitless. I have, never seen the movie Limitless. But apparently there's a TV show coming out where, I guess, in Limitless... Tell the people again what it was about.
Basically, if everyone's seen the movie, there's this drug that allows you to open portions of your brain, more portions of your brain. Like I was saying, the 10 parts are open up to like 30 or 40%.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can like memorize things, literally give yourself a week and you could do anything. You can become an astronaut, you can become a senator, you can pretty much become the president if you wanted to.
Mm. Which is absolutely amazing. And during the course of the movie, this guy figured out how to make it permanent. Now, the TV show is picking up from where...
Yeah, at the end of the movie where it ended.
Yeah, where it ended, and he's interviewing candidates for the next...
Something like that, because this one guy finds the drug in a potted plant, and then he goes through the same process, and then he goes to the hospital because that's the withdrawal effect. If you don't keep taking the drug, you will become dumb.
Oh, really?
You become dumb and stupid because you can't concentrate anymore, because the drug does that to you. So if you don't take a constant flow of the drug or make it permanent, then you become dumb.
Like, the withdrawal is a permanent effect?
Yeah, it's permanent effect.
Oh.
Because it's been part of your bloodstream for so long.
Wow.
So, yeah, you would literally become dumb if you don't take it. So, this guy takes it, he feels like the king of the world, and then he has the effects because the drug wears off, and he, goes to the hospital, and then the guy from the movie, I can't remember the actor's name, sees him and says, "We should talk."
Mm.
And that's pretty much where the trailer ended off.
Oh.
But yeah, so from my opinion, I'm thinking that he's trying to build candidates.
Whoa.
Yeah, I didn't see you there for
a
second.
You got lucky.
Yeah. The guy I was really worried about is the guy above me who has a fault mold of cocktails.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just gonna hide in here for a bit.
Although
it would be a bad hot box right about now.
But... yeah, and that led me to wondering about our potential as human beings, because it seems like, and just how powerful species we are, because here we have all of this. Really?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
That's the good thing that they don't see my partner running around like a dodo.
No.
There we go again.
Wow.
See, right there. The second
you saw it.
The first one I knew I was going to miss.
Oh my gosh.
I forgot I could
count. Oh, nice. He's dead.
Yeah, my brother hit him in the head. Shot him in the head.
Good deal, bro.
Look at his face. Look at that face.
Oh my God, it shattered.
I know, right?
Good shot, bro. It sucks that you used me as a decoy, but fuck you.
Yeah. That guy's dead now.
But it's like we have all this... potential that we...
Yeah, I'm gonna hide back in the
shadows.
I know, my brother was getting in the way.
Bro!
Okay, it was one behind me, I think. Hold on, wait for it. Okay,
Where are you, motherfucker?
I can get this guy. Hopefully the guy behind me won't show up behind me and try to shoot me in the back.
Yeah, but it's like...
Oh, crap, my leg's right there! Ooh, you missed!
Go, bro!
You're sick! You sick? What? I'm trying to say you suck. Really, this shows you why I am a foreigner here, because my English is not so good. I'm trying to remember if English is my first... No, you don't!
Yeah!
Counter-attack!
Nice counter!
Yeah, when I actually have health, I can counter easy.
Nice!
Yeah. As I was trying to say, English is either my second or third language.
That's all of them. Sweet. Did you hit a checkpoint?
I don't... Well, hold on. I think we're almost done, actually, because I think we're almost... If there's a big group, then we'll stop. But I'm pretty sure after this, we... find Ellie.
Yeah, well, I'm just going to keep talking.
Oh, okay. I don't know if you wanted to end the video here or not.
No, keep going.
Okay.
We're not there yet.
Oh, we're not? Oh, that was just me thinking back of me just dying over and over again previously. That's why.
Yeah, we haven't, like, done that too much this one.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we got like, 5 more minutes.
So at least they don't have to worry about the Marauders anymore. We pretty much killed them all.
Well, you know, it's crazy. The horse is like, coast to clear? Great.
Yeah.
Hey, we missed you guys. You sons of bitches ran without us. Not really?
Yeah.
We don't see it that way. We're giving you room to work.
Yeah. Best way to put it.
He
doesn't like this. He don't like this at all.
Nah.
He's like, I remember what happened the last time I jumped over something.
Yeah. But like I was saying, the limitless potentials, how did she even make it through here?
I think she didn't stop. I guess, I think that's what, she made them draw attention to us. They were probably like, you know, goofing off or something. She just ran by. And then we come in and said, oh, there's the other horses. Get them.
Well, our potential as human beings, it's amazing. It just leaves me to wonder, like, how much further we can progress, because it seems like we're constantly evolving, and if we're like the sentient creatures that know that there's more to us than what we can currently do, we just don't know how to tap into it.
Yeah, well, there are some people who theorize that we've stopped because we invented things to help us. Some people think that if we didn't build planes sooner or later, that we may have actually been able to grow wings or something and fly, or if we needed to go live underwater, stuff like that. It's technically true because we've invented things that evolution has helped everybody else. So technically, I guess, so there's other ways to evolve that we have to figure out.
Really?
Yeah. Or find ways to help increase, which is one thing is man and machine becoming one, not an actual cyborg, but actually living metal.
Really?
Basically. I think the closest thing that's ever been shown that popped in my head right now was in Mass Effect 3.
Really?
Where there was an ending that you could choose, which was the green ending, where you basically become this living metal thing. You were both organic and inorganic at the same time.
Wasn't that like Megatron in the last Transformers movie?
Not really.
Oh. Because I thought he was.
It's basically, it's skin, but it's also circuitry, metal, power,
so
all
like
that stuff.
Nanotechnology?
To the extreme. Organic nanomachines.
Wow. So
but
like,
but your tendons, your muscles, everything, that is machine.
So technically, it would be like viruses that would constantly reconstruct your body out of inorganic material.
Something like that. I'm trying to figure out the best way to put it. So basically you are a machine, but not the machine that we know. If you're not like a computer or a laptop, all that stuff, just imagine a laptop like what you have right there, but it's organic. So the buttons and everything are actually living organisms. They're not just dead machinery.
Don't we have something like that already?
Not really. Not on this scale. Like a living person becoming a hybrid of man and machine together as one.
No, I mean, don't we have things that are like...
rats.
Wow, they were big.
Yeah.
I mean, don't we have something that's...
We have something that's living metal, but not that type.
Yeah.
We have this the ones I was telling you about that can heal themselves. It'd be like that. So just imagine machinery, nanomachines, or an actual human being, but he can actually become... there's a lot of things. He can have basically the mind of a computer. He can literally upgrade himself, but not because of, like, new parts or anything. He would focus it and his body would be able to do that.
That's cool.
So you would upgrade yourself like fast evolution because you had a mix of both. So let's say like you lose a finger, you think about it, the circuitry and nanomachines would be able to rebuild it back up again.
That's cool.
Because, you know, you have the living organism to replace that because of the body parts.
So would that be like the Terminator? From Terminator 2?
Something, yeah. So basically it'd be like that, but instead of us becoming like a blob and everything, it's like have you seen the third Terminator?
Yes, I think.
The one where it had both of those combined, liquid and the metal, that's basically what it is. So we would be like that.
Okay.
So we would be the best of both worlds without having the drawback, because you know, with machinery you need power, cells and all this other stuff, and living organisms, you need to have things to eat, drink, and all this other stuff, but you combine both of them so you'd have the best of both worlds without actually having none of the drawback.
Mmm, that's cool.
Yeah, so that's what people would have to say, that what we may have to aspire to, figure out to become stuff like that.
Mmm.
The Bash must have been a very famous band.
They had to have been.
I was looking to see if, so let's, because I've been trying to look around here for all the goodies.
2013.
Yep, alright, so, any other goodies here? Yes, tape, oops, scissors.
Shiv.
Yeah, how much do I have a, I only had like one part of a shiv.
Wow.
Alright, I'm going to build a Molotov cocktail because I needed one of those.
Well, we made it.
Yeah, we finally made it. I think I'm about to say I don't want to be in a room where she is yet because I'm still looking around.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that is everything. Or is she hiding in here? No. Okay, she is in that room. But yeah, it's something to think about.
Oh yeah, it's a ton of stuff to think about.
Ooh, bathroom. That's a good shower.
What are you doing getting clean in here?
Yeah, running water probably wouldn't have been a good thing. Probably been all brown and mossy.
Yeah.
Then again, she probably wouldn't have to worry about getting infected by the water if the water can get infected. Where is she?
I don't know.
I think we've been there. No, we haven't been. I was about to say, where is she? I was like, oh, I haven't checked this room yet. Durr.
Well, it's a two bathroom.
I don't think it's a three bathroom. I think there's one downstairs, too.
Oh, so it's like three bedroom, two and a half bath.
Yeah. Yep. All right, here she is. Oh, flannel shirt.
Nice.
Is this really all they had to worry about? Boys, movies.
Wow, I'm surprised that diary is still there.
It's bizarre.
Get up. We're leaving.
And if I say no?
Do you even realize what your life means? Huh? Running off like that, putting yourself at risk? It's pretty goddamn stupid.
Well, I guess we're both disappointed with each other then.
What do you want from me?
Admit that you wanted to get rid of me the whole time.
Tommy knows this area.
Oh, fuck. Better than...
Well, I'm sorry. I trust him better than I trust myself.
Stop with the bullshit.
No, trust me, that isn't.
What are you so afraid of? That I'm going to end up like Sam? I can't get infected.
Oh, but you can still die.
How many close calls have we had?
Well, we seem to be doing all right so far.
And now you'll be doing even better with Tommy.
Yep.
Not her, you know.
What?
Maria told me about Sarah.
Ellie? And... You are treading on some mighty thin ice here.
I'm sorry about your daughter, Joel. But I have lost people, too.
You have no idea what loss is.
Everyone I have cared for has either died or left me. Everyone... Fucking except for you.
Chuck Norris Jr. knows how to take care of himself.
Don't tell me that I would be safer with someone else, because the truth is I would just be more scared.
You're right. You're not my daughter. And I sure as hell ain't your dad. And we are going our separate ways.
Get it together. We're not alone.
Oh, I guess the rest of the Marauders found out about us.
Wow.
There are two walking in.
There's more inside already.
Wow.
Yeah, tough talk!
Oh, and?
Yeah, whoop!
Alright, so, what a way to end it!
Yeah, heart-to-heart talk, huh?
Heart-to-heart talk after Mobius loops and Clein bottles again. Mm-hmm. And what it means to have consciousness and do all this other crap. Boy, deep conversations, but really conversations. So we will continue this next time. So thank you so much for joining us. I am Shay.
I'm Matt Hatter.
And we will see you all in the next video.
Bye-bye.